rise of a company called India Globalization Capital. It's soaring. It's a cannabis pharmaceutical company, and they're getting into pot-infused drinks. Bring in John Carter, Simpler Trading CEO. John, welcome to the show.
Stuart, thanks for having me here.
So, you watch these cannabis stocks, don't you? You're an observer of the pot scene, so to speak, from the outside, so to speak.
Typically from the outside. One of the things, you know, and that was a great rant, by the way, and one of the things that I think is that if the American media actually drank more CBD-infused beverages, they might chill out a little bit.
You mean I should do this?
Yeah, it'd be great. It'd be a good thing. And then, you know, just everybody can relax about the New York Times pieces and things like that.
So what's with this global... I can't see again. What's the name of that stock again? Put it up on the screen again, will you?
Oh, the global growth?
Yeah, what's that all about?
So what's interesting here is now in Canada, they've recently been allowed or given approval to start exporting cannabis to the U.S. starting October 17th. So some of these companies that are in Canada, they actually have already had huge investments by large companies, so that kind of gives them a vote of confidence. It's not like some guy in a garage that decided to list a stock. So it's a way to participate in what's, in truth, a speculative portion of the market in companies, what I would call real companies.
Okay. I'm told that there's enormous numbers of people who are betting against the cannabis stocks. They short them. That's the way they look at it. You're short
sure.
them. You're expecting them to go down. You're betting that they go down. Is that accurate?
It is. And what's interesting with this is you get the large hedge funds, which normally the idea is that you hear hedge funds and it's like, oh my gosh, these guys.
So this is a really interesting bet. Obviously, for me, I'm not going to invest in either side. I think that cannabis is obviously a great market, but you know, I've already taken enough risk with crypto. And once again, you have to really wait for regulators and see how it plays out. And like I said, unfortunately, in this kind of thing, I do feel like you're at a disadvantage unless you're going to be a long-term holder. And unless you can get inside information and figure out which U.S. companies have political influence and you know, who's going to dictate who the winners are going to be, it's a big risk. So for me, I would rather just hold my crypto and stay away from cannabis for now. Continue to watch it because I do feel like it is a growing market and there is good opportunity, but realize it's highly controlled by the government. So whoever is going to get into it, I do believe it's going to be a lot like, you know, alcohol and tobacco and even technology, where it's literally going to be two or three major players that can basically buy the economy of scales, pay off politicians to get regulations to favor them, and they're going to be the winner. So you can try to find these stocks that will hopefully shoot to the moon, but it's very speculative. But let me know your thoughts on this, and I will talk to you soon.